everyone, it's Kelly, and welcome back to the Rose Project. Well, developments. It is finally not 5,000 degrees outside, so I don't feel like I'm dying just sitting in my room, which is great, and it also means that I can go to the gym without feeling like I'm completely dying. Like, I'm out of shape, but at least I'm not, you know, lying on the floor sweating for an hour as opposed to, you know, the 15 minutes they already do, but whatever. Anyway, that is a subject for another week. This week we're going to be talking about, you know, the SMART goals that I made that last week and the developments I've had up to this point. So, did I follow my SMART goals? Sort of. I had one thing standing in my way of me and the goals that I was making. The dining hall. So I was thinking of coming into you guys and preaching to you guys about how terrible the dining hall is and how bad it is for you. But really, I was looking more into it, and the dining halls, at least here on my campus, they really try to give you healthy and balanced meals. While each station is not as healthy as another, they always try their best to keep them as healthy as possible, at least in some respect. For example, I'm able to download an app onto my phone that allows me to look up the calorie contents and all the different ingredients that go into all the meals I'm eating, so I know exactly what I'm putting into my system and I can plan it out even before I get to the dining hall. And I find that using that planning tool actually helps me stay healthier at the dining hall, so I'm able to have a plan and go in and know exactly what I'm gonna eat before I get there, and that will help me not stray away to other things like, you know, a second plate of brownies or another cone of ice cream or even an entire other entree that I want to eat. In the end, I know a lot of dining halls at schools aren't perfect, and we're not perfect, so as much as they stray away from keeping us healthy, we stray away from keeping ourselves healthy, because there's so many tempting options. I mean, that cheesy shrimp pasta, it's so good, but is it the best for you? No, and you should probably go to the vegan station. Does it taste as good? No, but at least you're feeling a little bit better about yourself after eating. Now, another important thing is to not eat so little that you're feeling unsatisfied. You want to feel full after your meal without feeling completely stuffed, which is why it's always good to stock up on a good amount of healthy sides, like applesauce, for example, really good for you, and if you add cinnamon on top, adds an extra kick to it, and it makes it taste a lot better, too, not so bland. I also try and eat a lot of my fruits more in the afternoon because they have a lot of complex components to them that it takes your body a long time to break those down. So the earlier you eat those in the day, the longer you are awake and active, so the more opportunity your body has to break those down throughout your activity in the day. When you eat them later in the day or for like a later snack in the day, your body won't have as much time to process those components and break them down, which leaves you a lot that you're actually sleeping on and keeping inside your system. So am I perfect? No. Did I follow my goal to a T? No. I did not eat only one dessert during the week. I realized about halfway through the week, I absolutely cannot do this. I need a cookie now or I think I'm gonna die. Spoiler alert, I probably wouldn't have died, but I still really wanted a cookie and I had a cookie. Then I had another cookie, and then maybe another cookie. Maybe I had some wings. Is that perfect? No. But I'm still able to feel good about myself because I know that I'm making a lot of progress, and I ate a lot less unhealthy stuff than I would have probably a few weeks ago before I had started this project. And progress is what matters, not being perfect. I learned in elementary school when we were kind of learning about the scientific process that failure in an experiment is not actually a technical failure. You're still getting an outcome, you're still learning something about whatever science project or process that you're doing. So here, failing in my goal actually helps me learn more about myself and how I should tailor my goals to my own experiences and who I am as a person. So now I know for further goals I set, I probably shouldn't cut myself off from so many sweets. Just have myself, you know, eat less of them and continue to improve each week. Like I told you guys before, this isn't a one-step process. You're not gonna wake up one day and then be thin and fit and be eating perfectly. It's an evolution. You're essentially evolving as a person. And the thing about evolution is usually when it happens, you're getting better. So we're getting better as people. That doesn't happen overnight. My goal for you guys this week is when you go out to eat, when you go to the dining hall, I want you to be able to say to yourself after your meal, wow, I'm really glad that I had this at my meal because it's going to make me healthier and a better person. Even if it's just one thing, even if it's not your entire meal, even if you had like dessert after lunch maybe, it's okay. You just have to be able to say to yourself, wow, I'm really glad I ate this thing and it makes me feel better, because then you're more motivated to feel better about yourself later by eating good things, if that makes sense. Well, I had a very busy Monday and I have a lot of homework. So it is time for me to get to my homework so I do not fail out of school. So I will see all of you next week on the Rose Project, and just remember that you are exactly where you're supposed to be.